Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Anesthesiologist. Welcome to my channel. If you subscribe and alarm, you can get the best information about Gemstones and Jewelry. As you look at the list of topics, I'm going to teach everyone from basic to advanced course step by step. Today's topic is the Jewelry of Edwardian Era. The Edwardian Era got its name from Edward VII as the English King. Edwardian Jewelry is the last jewelry period of British monarch. As derived from the French word rocaille, Rococo style originated in Paris in the early 18th century. It is characterized by elegance, curve, undulation, and modeled on nature. You can see Rococo style at Versailles, Palace in Paris. Rococo painting in France began with the elegant, finished in the playful and sensuous nudes of François Boucher, and ended with the pearly paint scenes of Jean-Honoré Bragonard. In the Edwardian era, Cartier has a history of sales to royalty. King Edward VII reported to Cartier as the jeweler of kings and the king of jewelers. He ordered 27 tiaras for his coronation and issued a royal warrant to Cartier. As landmark of New York, Cartier building is located on the corner of 52nd Street and Phipps Avenue in New York City. This building was constructed in 1904. Messrs. Cartier acquired the mansion from Brandt in 1917. Cartier developed using platinum as Garland style. Necklace of floral decoration was designed by Invisible Setting. Also, platinum and diamond saltwater necklace with lavalier pendant was produced. As the second wife of Grand Duke Paul Alexandrovich, Olga Karlovich wore diamond jewelry of the Cartier. Wealthy women of Edwardian era wore jewelry on the exposed skin and was gaudily dressed gown. Peter Karl Pavlovich was a Russian jeweler, best known for the famous Pavlovich eggs. He made Rachel Pavlovich eggs by order of Charles. As you can see, the absorber egg was presented by Alexander III as an Easter gift to his wife Maria Fyodorovna. In addition, Pavlovich showed many goods to his shop as follows: floral decoration with jewelry, small opera glasses, handle of parasol, and etc. However, his main products were Pavlovich eggs. There are the Napoleonic egg, Memory of Absorb egg, Imperial Coronation egg, the Duchess of Marlborough egg, Gatchina Palace Pavlovich egg, Release of the Belly, Bouquet of Release. If you want to get more information, please watch my other videos about Pavlovich eggs. As a pound of Boucheron brand, Frederick Boucheron became the first jeweler to move to Place Vendôme. He thought that the diamond in the window would sparkle more brilliantly because the shop was located in the sunniest corner of the square. Boucheron's VIP customers were Grand Horizontal and Imperial families of Russia. Boucheron offered innovative design to high society such as diamond jewelry with floral motif and high-quality pearls. American heiress Consuela Vanderbilt got married to Charles Richard John Spencer Churchill, the 9th Duke of Marlborough and the most eligible peer in Great Britain. She had been arranged through the mechanism of her socially thriving mother. She prepared a lot of bottom drawer for a better social status. Main characteristics of the Edwardian era are invisible setting, Garland style, dull-colored charcoal, and hair ornaments. Especially imperial family's women wore the aigrette, the bandeau, the tiara, and the hatpin. Okay, let's do a quiz. Question: which brand were famous in the Edwardian era? Answer: Cartier, Pavlovich, and Boucheron were famous for high-end jewelry. Thank you for watching my video. If this lecture is useful to you, please subscribe and share with your friends. Also, if you watch my other videos, you can get more information about gemstones. See you next video. Have a great day.